Hello, welcome to my channel Mechanical Engineering Concept. Today I am continuing my previous topic, which is dynamics of fluid, in which I am going to discuss about Euler's equation of motion, which I am discussed in earlier classes of basics. I am going to derive the Euler equation of motion. So to derive the Euler equation of motion, considering a fluid element length ds and cross section area is dA, in which at one end of a fluid element pressure into area, it means load acting, pressure into dA. Why dA is considering here? Because the pressure is acting at this cross section area dA. On the other hand, the pressure will increase with respect to del P by del S into ds P. Here weight of fluid is acting downwards, which is mass into gravity. We know that mass density is the mass upon volume. Volume here is dA into ds. So rho g dA ds will be the weight of the fluid, because once again I am repeating, weight is equal to mass into gravity. Mass can be written as volume into density. Density here is rho, density of fluid, and volume can be written as dA into ds. dA will be the cross section area, ds will be the length of the fluid. So the total volume will be dA into ds. So considering the equilibrium condition, so P into dA minus, because on the other end of the fluid end the pressure will be in the other direction, on the opposite direction. So P plus del P by del S into ds into dA minus weight component will be taken in here as a component of theta. So rho g dA ds cos theta equal to acceleration, because here the flow will occur from here to here like this. Okay, so mass into acceleration will be written as rho into volume, density into volume. Density here is rho, volume will be d into ds, acceleration will of flow is a into s, as s will be a subscript. So simplifying this equation, the resulting equation will come out as this, because P and dA will be cancelled from the both end. The resulting equation will be this. AS can be written as dV by dt, derivative of velocity with respect to time. Simplifying partial equation, partially. So del V by del S by ds by dt is equal to del V by del t. Because here the velocity flow will be negligible considering, because the steady flow condition I am assuming. So due to steady flow condition, del V by del T will be equal to 0. So the resultant will be del V by del S by dS by dt. dS by dt can be written as velocity component V d del S by del V by del S resultant. So putting this here, I'm taking here our resulting equation as P minus T del P by del S, del S by del A from this term, and rho G D A D S cos theta will be here, and from to right hand side will be this. Yes, we'll put them from here. Dividing both the end with respect to rho D A D S. With respect to rho d a d s from both end, so dividing this, we can resultant, our resultant equation will be like this, because from here d a d s will be cancelled out, only rho will be remainder from denominator, and here also d a d s will be cancelled out. With respect to rho, g will be remaining. equal to n, the v del v by del x will be remaining. So this term we taking from equal to this end to this end, and negative sign will be taken as common. So resulting equation will be 1 by rho del p by del s plus g into del v del z by del s. Why del v by del s? Cos theta I am taking this element from this element, elementary equation. Taking this triangle, this is the length of element ds, length of fluid element. This vertical height is, I am taking here as a del z, which is a head height of the fluid. Vertically, this is the angle theta making this fluid element. So cos theta will be dz by ds, putting this here. So resulting will be 1 by rho del p by del s plus g del z by del s plus v into del v by del s is equal to 0. Taking 1 by ds common, 1 by rho del v plus d g dz plus v into dv equal to 0 will be the final. So we know that 1 by ds cannot be 0. So the this term can be written as 0. So 1 by rho dp plus g dz plus v dv is equal to 0. This resultant equation will be known as Euler equation of motion for dynamics condition. For elementary equation, elementary fluid element, this which has a volume ds and dA. So this will be the Euler equation of motion, which is helpful to derive a Bernoulli's equation of motion for ideal fluid as well as for real fluid. I hope you understand the basic concept related to the Euler equation of motion. If you have any query related to this video, please tell me below this video in the comment box, and don't forget to subscribe my channel and press bell icon and send to notification button to get further update related to my channel. Thank you.